Okay, so now here we have my bird completely drawn out. This is my desert cardinal. And what we're going to be doing now is we're going to start painting it. The first material I've decided to use is watercolor paint. Now I've got two types of watercolor paint in the classroom. I've got these transparent watercolors by Grum Backer, and you open them up, and some of them have multiples of the same color, some of them have missing colors, some of them the colors are half gone, some of them are dirty, and it's just a matter of fixing them up. And fixing them up is actually quite easy if you have a paper towel on hand and some paintbrushes. I also have this palette right here. This is one of the ones that's actually mostly full, so you're able to use the three greens, your browns, your blues, purples, reds, yellows, black, gray, and there's white. Most of the white actually looks pink on a lot of them. That's because a lot of kids try to make pink with the watercolor paints, and they mix it here instead of on the paper or on the cover here. So when you want to mix paints, try to mix them on the covers, on another piece of paper or a piece of plastic. Don't mix them here because that actually dirties them up and prevents another student from using the correct color. Watercolor paints are actually pretty easy to use. You just have to know how to use them properly. And that's what I'm going to be going over today, really fast. So here's another sheet of paper. This one's actually super thin. I'm not using the correct paint brushes the way you guys have them here in the classroom because I'm sitting in my house and these are my brushes. So a watercolor brush is usually a little bit more flexible than the harder brushes. The ones with the brown handle that we've used for the color wheel, those are more tempera paint brushes. They're harder to use in the sense that the bristles don't have a lot of give to it the way these do. And I've got several different sizes that are going to help me with this painting. Now, the first thing you got to do, they're watercolor, so you need some water. We're going to start with this. I think this is brown. So we're going to put brown on my brush and then just paint. And this is just a little covering. You want it a little bit more, just use more paint, more water. You can go over it again and get the color that you want. Now, change colors, very simple. Let's see what this red looks like. Ooh, it's actually really pretty red. Now, for instance, we're going to talk about what we do when colors are on top of each other. Now, my bird happens to have red and blue in the same area. So I actually want to use some of the blue paint, and I'm going to put it on top of the red. Now, once the red is dry, you can paint right over it without a problem. And you can create all sorts of different things with your brush. Maybe this will help you make a feathery look or something like that. We'll go with it. Should move the water to the other side. And that's actually very, very simple and similar to what we're going to do. You are looking at your picture of your bird when you are painting, because you want to be able to see the colors of the bird, and you can't do that if you're not looking at the painting, at the picture. You want it to be as realistic as possible, and the only way to do that is to physically look at the painting. And in order to do that, I mean, look at the bird. We don't have birds in class, so we have to actually look at the picture. See, here I have my bird drawn, and I'm going to start by adding in some of the red. Now, This red looks like a really, really dark red. So I am actually going to use this palette. Maybe, let's see, and now we'll go with this brush. And we're going to go with this dark red here. So we get some water. We can test out the color. Ooh, I like that red. We're going to go with that red. So I want more water on my brush because I want to get more of that color out of the little palette there. And you see how it's all in my brush there? All of that red. All of that red is going to be used to paint in my bird. Now notice I'm holding the paintbrush all the way down here at the metal tip. This part that keeps the wood and the bristles together. And I'm using that to hold my brush steady. Now, so there's my red. Now I know I got some red on these little feathers up here. And I don't have any other small brushes, so I'm just going to go with it. And I know I got red on the head on the wings. Try to do one color at a time. It actually makes it a lot easier. That way you don't have to constantly be washing out your brush. There we go. Now I'm just getting down the base color. I'm going to worry about the actual details of the feathers later on. You want to make sure you at least get those base colors down first. This way, you know what goes where. Now, I'm going to continue painting. And while I'm doing that, I'm actually going to fast forward this video a little bit so you don't have to constantly watch it in slow-mo.
You live in the loop of smokes on the stoop, counting the coins you got. You work at a bar where all that you are is everything you're not. Someone tell me when I can start again and rewrite this story. See the hook, can't sell the look. I hear it every day.